Hello everyone, and welcome to the Speculative Wildlife Research Center, an art and science-based channel where we will be reimagining creatures and monsters from TV, video games, and more through the lens of speculative biology. But first, what even is speculative biology? Well, speculative biology or speculative evolution is a genre of science fiction that applies scientific principles and knowledge about biology, ecology, and evolution to creature design and world building. You see, our world is populated by an amazing diversity of plants, animals, fungi, and microorganisms, and none of these exist in a vacuum. All living beings on Earth are being molded by their environment across the generations, meaning that creatures will evolve a certain way, look a certain way, and act a certain way, depending on a diversity of factors. How they feed, what they feed on, how they avoid being eaten, how they navigate their habitat, and how they survive to bring new generations of their species into the world. Thus, speculative biology is the creation of living things, ecosystems, and even whole worlds with a firm basis on how and why these beings exist, and how they interact with each other and the world around them, treating them as if they were real living creatures and giving a much more lifelike quality to them. Mind you, these creatures are not meant to be in any way inherently better than those created only through imagination. Both are only different methods to achieve the same goal, to imagine and to create. Speculative evolution is usually thought to have started with H.G. Wells' novel, The Time Machine, which features future beings evolved from modern-day people and animals. However, modern speculative biology is usually considered to have begun with the works of Dougal Dixon, especially with his book After Man, which depicts a future world where, after man's disappearance, animal life has evolved in new ways, many times similarly to previous beings and occupying the same roles as them. Dixon gives particular care to showing us how extinction and niche availability allow species to develop and diversify. Another of his books, The New Dinosaurs, shows how dinosaurs could potentially have evolved had they not become extinct. Nowadays, people from all over the world are capable of sharing their own speculative biology and evolution projects to the internet, further diversifying the reach of such a fascinating genre. All in all, works of speculative biology can focus on a wide diversity of topics, from alternative evolutionary paths for creatures from our own world, both living and extinct, and future possibilities for existing ecosystems, to new worlds with conditions and evolutionary histories completely different to our own. Despite seeming constrained by the application of scientific principles, speculative biology is really limited only by the imagination. Here in this channel, we will be applying speculative biology to creatures we know and love from all over the realms of fiction and fantasy, in order to imagine what they might look like as living, breathing beings. So get ready, and let's start speculating.